Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Zyrowski from newvisionexcel.com, and in this video, what we're going to do is talk about the benefits of intermittent fasting. So intermittent fasting is something that I've used for years. It's something that has been a great benefit to me, and you know, I want to share that information with you so that you can get the benefits, you can understand it, and you know, hopefully it'll change your life. So intermittent fasting is used by many celebrities, actors like Hugh Jackman, Terry Crews, singers like Beyonce, all really tout the benefits that they've received from intermittent fasting. And what intermittent fasting is it's not a diet. It's simply a period in which you're going to eat your food throughout the day. So instead of, you know, waking up in the morning and eating first thing and then eating throughout the day, whenever you feel like it, basically what you do is you eat all your meals within an 8-hour period. So a couple popular ways to do intermittent fasting is like 16 and 8, for instance, 16 hours of fasting and 8 hours of eating. Okay, so it just means you eat your meals all within that 8-hour period. Now, another way some people do it is 20 hours of fasting in a 4-hour period in which you eat your meals. Now, when you're doing intermittent fasting, it's not about calorie restriction. It has nothing to do with that. It's just simply eating the same amount of calories you normally would, but within a shorter time frame versus grazing all day long. Now let's go ahead and talk about some of the benefits that you can get from intermittent fasting. So first is that you're really going to burn fat while you're intermittent fasting. The reason for this is because our body holds about 6 to 8 hours of glycogen stores, meaning that our body will burn stored sugar for energy for about 6 to 8 hours. But after those stores are gone, it actually turns to the fat cells to energize the body. So what you're going to see from this is you're going to see the fat cells start to just go away on the body because we're using them and consuming them for energy. The next big thing that intermittent fasting does for you is it actually lowers your insulin levels, lowers and balances them. And along with balancing those insulin levels, it also helps a couple other hormones. It makes hormones like leptin, which tells your body to burn fat, more sensitive so that it's telling your body to burn more fat more often and your body can hear it better. And then the other thing it does is it makes your body more sensitive to a hormone called ghrelin. Ghrelin is that hormone that's actually responsible for telling your body you're full. So some people who become hormone insensitive, they keep eating and they're not getting that signal from their body telling them that they're full and they should stop eating. The next big thing that intermittent fasting does for you is it boosts your immune system. By boosting your immune system, you're less likely to get sick. It also decreases inflammation. And remember, folks, if you're decreasing inflammation, you are literally preventing disease in your future because inflammation is the root cause of all disease. Now, the fourth big benefit of intermittent fasting is the increase of tissue healing and repair. So this is why people who are working out love it so much, because they see that with intermittent fasting, they're able to actually get those gains much faster and progress through their workouts. And so when you are doing intermittent fasting, what's happening is your human growth hormone, HGH, is just skyrocketing. It's been seen in the literature to increase in upwards of 2,000% in men and 1,300% in women when doing intermittent fasting and doing high intensity interval training prior to your first meal. And so if you want to increase your recovery in the gym and you want to increase healing and tissue growth, then intermittent fasting is really good. And you know, I also need to mention that when you increase this HGH levels, it has this anti-aging effect on the body as well. Now, one of the reasons that HGH is boosted so much during intermittent fasting is because insulin is driven down. And when insulin is driven down, that HGH is actually able to go higher because insulin actually blunts the HGH to not be able to be in high levels within the body when you're eating just a standard American diet and just grazing all day. Now, the fifth and last thing I want to mention that is a huge benefit to intermittent fasting is that you'll have increased energy. Now, about 5 to 15% of our energy is actually expended through digestion. So when we are not just grazing all day and digesting all day, our body has so much more you know, energy to go in and, you know, feel good and heal and just, you know, it conserves that energy because it's not all being expended through digestion. So if you want to increase your energy, intermittent fasting is a really great way to do that as well. Now, a couple last things I want to mention about intermittent fasting, just so that you're really set off on the right foot and you're doing it correctly. One is that you need to be eating a high quality diet like the one outlined in the Heal Yourself Cookbook. And the reason for this is because if you're eating a standard American diet, lots of sugar, it's just not a good thing to put your body through intermittent fasting, because it can be more harmful than good if you're not eating a good quality diet. So make sure you're eating a good high quality diet, no processed foods, and decreasing the amount of sugar and doing all the right things. Now, the other thing that's really important to mention is that if you want to drink black coffee or tea or something along those lines in the morning, you can put a sweetener like xylitol or stevia or erythritol in it. But if you put sugar in it, you will break the fast. I've heard some people who say, they do intermittent fasting, but they drink bulletproof coffee in the morning. Well, you can't consume all that butter and cream and possibly sugar and still stay in that fasted state. That's going to spike your metabolism, and then that wouldn't be intermittent fasting. Then the next big thing to mention is that you can shift your hours. So if it's, whether you like 16 and 8 or maybe 18 and 6 or 20 and 4, whatever fits you best, go ahead and play with it a little bit. You can have your first meal earlier in the morning and then your last meal later or earlier in the evening. So there's so many different variations that you can do to change it up and make sure that, intermittent fasting is right for you. And then last if not least, if you want more information on intermittent fasting, go ahead and look down below. I'll post all the links of all the articles I've written on intermittent fasting. I hope this benefits you greatly. Until next time, make it a great day.